UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
So continuing to yesterday's session, yesterday we were discussing about controller. So here controller basically it is going to contain a scenario. So whatever we are going to create in controller will be called as a scenario. So basically a scenario is going to contain a virtual user script with load, some load generator. Okay. So here a virtual user script can also be can be saved as, one virtual user script can be have multiple virtual users. I mean to say here, in this particular scenario, say here registration is a one scenario which can be done from UK, US, from India. So in that case, so the scenario is same, but the way of the execution may differ from place to place. I mean, say if you are executing, say the server is in USA and if you are trying to access from USA, maybe it may be a bit fast, and moreover it also depends on the network. So to emulate the network, so we'll keep one load generator in one location, and to also consider that network, say if you are accessing from UK, so we also need to consider the network. So that's the reason we also keep one machine in UK. So we'll connect all these machines in the controller. Probably once I show, you'll get understand what actually I'm talking about. Okay. So we'll jump into this one. So here actually I was trying to explain virtual user script, load generator, number of users. So basically in the introduction to scenarios in the sense, in a controller we can create something called scenario. Okay. A scenario is going to contain the basic elements is this one. Okay. It is contain a virtual user script, load generator and number of users. So these are the things that a scenario is going to contain, and that scenario is a part of the controller. And if you see here we have two types of scenarios here available in controller. Okay, two types of scenarios, manual scenario and goal oriented scenario. So here in controller, we can create two types of scenarios. Manual scenario goal oriented scenario. Okay, so here as part of manual scenario, okay let me talk about first of all goal oriented. The name itself is saying this is the execution which depends on a particular goal. Say for example, my goal is that, first let's talk about the goal oriented scenario here. Okay, my goal is that login transaction should execute with 200 simultaneous users, and I want to know what is the, login transaction should be, say let me say 2 seconds, okay, say 2 seconds with some 200 users. I'm expecting that login transaction should done in 2 seconds, and it should be with 200 concurrent users. Okay, say with 200 concurrent users in the sense, simultaneously there should be 200 users. Okay, and at the time I'm expecting login transaction should be 2 seconds. So to achieve this, so it may talk about what is the hardware required to get this kind of scenario, to achieve this goal, which will let us know that what kind of hardware that we need to use, okay, what type of resources that we have to use. So it will let us know the things. Okay, goal oriented means the name itself is saying here we'll have a goal. So we'll set that goal, and once we set that goal, accordingly it will try to execute, and it will let us know now if you want to reach this particular goal, it will say that you have to execute with this many resources, with this many users and all. Say for example, you know, there is something called hits per second. We'll be discussing about this. What is meant by hits per second, we'll be discussing. Okay, there is some measurement called hits per second. Okay, so as I said, we'll be discussing hits per second. As of now, just assume this is one of the measurement, one of the characteristics of a web application. Okay, one of the characteristic of a server. Okay, so here I will say that, you know, 200 hits per second, 200 hits per second. Per second, I'm saying. Okay, it means 200 hits should be there it should reach the server. Okay, I'm expecting minimum 200 hits per second should be there for a server to achieve this goal. How many users that we have to pump, and what are the resources required? Those kind of things will let us know by the goal oriented scenario. But in general, in real time, generally we will not use goal oriented scenario, because here, in a reality, in a real time, you know, our aims will be like, our goals will be like this. Say here we will know, say in a real time, what we'll have, you know, customer says that, 1 minute, Amo, So here in a manual scenario, basically, generally in real time. I was not I did not explain at that time nothing. Okay. I realized that we lost the audio connection. That's the reason I did not discuss anything at the time. So I was talking about goal-oriented scenario. Then now we are talking about manual scenario. Basically, in a manual scenario, what will happen here in general? Say for example, if you are talking about eBay, and client says that I will be having 50,000 users. Okay, 50,000 users will access my application, and minimum it should maintain around 30,000 concurrent users. Okay, so scenario. A person will come like this. They will say that my application is going to be used by 50,000 users, and I have say some 5 servers. Okay. I have my application may be used by 50,000 users, and I have 5 servers, and I have some hardware configuration. He may say that I will be having some hardware configuration, like I have 5 servers. Just for example, say I have some 50 terabyte RAM. Of course, I'm just saying some number over here. I'm just trying to explain some concept here. Okay. So here basically a client says that this is my expected load, and this is my configuration over here. Okay, this is the configuration. Maybe this may not, he may not say, a client may come with something like, so technically what we call it as 50,000 users, technically what we call, yesterday we have discussed one terminology for this. So technically, what we call this 50,000 as, load, right? Okay, users or user load, yes, load. Okay. So client says that my application may be used by these 50,000 users, and this is the hardware configuration that I have, or maybe I can spend on this much hardware configuration. I can afford this much hardware configuration. In that case, I would like to know what is the login transaction. I would like to know what is the login time it is going to take? Okay, like what is the item, what is the time it is going to take out for the checkout? Okay, so what is the time it is going to take by the eBay for checking out? Okay, so your client will try to expect what kind of what is the transaction time it is taking and how much hits per second it has been generating for this particular load, for this particular configuration. I would like to know how much time it is going to take for each transaction and what is the hits per second, okay, and what is the maximum concurrent users. Like this, client may wanted to interested to know some metrics and say for example, I have time it is showing us some say 4 seconds here, and client is expecting some 2 seconds. In that case, we'll look into the issue. We can look at the alternatives, what we can do, whether we can increase the some hardware, and sometimes increasing the hardware may not purpose our problem. Okay, it always say if we start increasing the hardware, it may not solve our problem. We may also look into the database queries. Is that related to database issue or is that related to the logic that the developer has written? Okay, it all depends. So we'll come back to that particular analysis part. Okay, we will be discussing those things as part of analysis. As of now here, say client says that this is my load and this is my this is my investment. I can invest on these configurations. At that time, he may would like to know these kind of things. So if you all remember, we have discussed one thing or something called load testing. Did you all remember? If you look at the definitions that we have understood, can you all see this? We understood three types of testing: load testing, stress testing, volume testing. Okay. So in general, we do in real time load testing. Okay. So which is equivalent to performance testing. And the meaning of testing is testing the application and the customer expected load with the customer expected configuration. Okay, if you observe here, we already discussed about this one. Okay, so this is the customer application and customer is expecting this much load. Okay, and here here maximum concurrent users say like their expectation this one. Okay, and they says that this is my hardware configuration, and at that time, what is the time that is taken for the login? Okay, what is the time taken for the loading the QTP course content, and what is the time it is taking for opening the Selenium video file and all? Okay. However, here customer is having some load, customer is expecting some load, and customer is expecting some hardware configuration to be there. So with the things we are going to test. So mainly we do load testing in real time. Stress testing generally will not do this. Generally, because it involves with the cost. Okay, until unless it is a very 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 important application, generally will not go for stress testing. And stress testing, it's simple. Let's you will start increasing the number of users. Okay, say our expectation is 50,000 users. Maybe we'll start test the application with 60,000 users, 70,000 users, 80,000 users, and you will try to break it. Okay. However, so in general we do load testing. So that can be done using the manual scenario. So here manual scenario means we'll have some load and we'll have some configuration here. Fine. Now, 1 minute. Let me see actually. Yep. So we trying to understand this one. And here there's how to choose the scenario. As I said, in general, we will be choosing the manual scenario because here we can configure the customer expected load and customer expected configuration. Whereas in a goal-oriented scenario, generally here we just configure the goal. Like I would like to know this much of hits per second, this much of transaction time that I'm expecting for a transaction. Okay, so it will let us know the other points. So generally we do manual scenario here. Okay, yeah, fine. Let me show how to create a scenario. Here controller, and I would highly recommend open the tools by right clicking, saying run as administrator. Sometimes some options may not be available if you open normally, so just try to open the tools by saying run as administrator. And again, in manual scenario there is something called a person percentage mode, without percentage mode. Okay. Again, here in manual scenario, we have two things. Without percentage. With percentage. We'll be discussing about this. Now everyone observe here manual scenario over here. I'm selecting manual scenario, and if you all agree here, basically it is going to show some set of scripts. What are the scripts that we have created? Okay, what are the scripts that we have created? It is going to show over here. Basically, the loadrunner that I installed earlier, it has been expired. Okay, so I have installed the loadrunner on my local machine. Okay. So here I did not create any script. Here I have one script, but this script is not, it does not have anything over here. It does not have anything over here. However, as of now, we'll make use of this, but you know, when we wanted to actually execute the script, at that time we will create one scenario, one script, or probably we'll copy from this virtual machine. Okay, we'll copy from this virtual machine and we'll paste over here, and we'll try to execute over here. However, as of now, we'll try to understand these two things over here. For example, if we select goal-oriented scenario and say here I'm selecting this particular scenario, these are the available scripts, and these scripts I want to use. Say here we have some 20 scripts here, okay? Say it is showing some scripts, some set of scripts which are related to Facebook, some set of scripts which are related to eBay, some set of scripts which are related to Gmail. Say I want to work on eBay, so I will be selecting the scripts which are related to eBay over here. You will select those scripts and will say that add. So these scripts will be mapped here in the scenario over here, okay? We'll do one thing. Otherwise, you know, first of all, we'll record our scripts. We'll record some dummy scripts, okay? Then we'll use over here. At least if we have two scripts, it will be easy for us to understand, okay? So let me do one thing. Let me say cancel. Otherwise, okay. Well, first, complete this goal-oriented scenario. For manual scenario, we'll be creating some two scripts over here. See, I have selected goal-oriented scenario, and if you observe, there is a manual scenario. So as of now, I'm selected goal-oriented scenario. Okay. Now, if you read this, allow loadrunner controller to create a scenario based on the goals you specify. It means we will specify the goals, and it will create the remaining things, like how many types of users, how many number of users, and it will let us know the other things. Now, let me click on OK. Now see here, if you observe here, by default it is showing a goal like 100 hits per second, okay, I'll do one thing, we'll try to understand hits per second because it has been repeating, right? First we'll understand hits per second and we'll come back. Any idea from anyone? What is meant by hits per second? Any guesses? If that's correct, Devin. If that's correct, Marilyn. Yep, good guesses. Great. Anu, it's almost there, but it's not exactly. It's very simple. If you all remember request and response, did you all remember request and response? Did you all remember the word request and response? Okay, hits per second is something like the number of requests, okay, that you send to the server. Say it 10 users, okay? We know that each user will communicate with the server, okay? Say each user sends some request to the server. So how many requests has been reached to the server per second, okay? How many requests has been reached to the server per second. you can say I can keep this in a smaller list. Okay, maybe we can, in other words, we can say request per second that has been reached to the server will be called as a hits per second. It is hitting the server, right? When a user is sending something to a server, how many hits, you know, that is reaching the server. So why it is so important? Because say here you send some 100 requests to the server. Now server should able to understand all the 100 requests, and it has to respond accordingly for all the 100 requests, right? That is capability of a server. How capable of your server? Say if your server can handle 1000 requests. Say if your server can handle 1000 requests, means it can handle 1000 users per second. It can interpret 1000 users requests and it can respond accordingly. I hope you are getting what I'm trying to say here. So 100 hits, 100 requests has been sent to the server. So each user sending some request to the server over here. Okay, in simple words, how many requests has been reaching to the server? I mean, if it is being solving, like say it is 1200, like that. So it has been understanding those many requests. So whenever there is more hits per second, okay, whenever there is more hits per second, means more number of requests has been sending from the users to the server over here. Say for example, yesterday I hope every one of you remember ramp up. You don't remember ramp up? Did you all remember ramp up? Yeah, great. So here it's like, you know, pumping up the users, right? Say for example, if I am sending 5 users per second, okay? Say if I am sending, if I am pumping the 5 users per second, and say we are doing this for 1 minute here. What will happen? I mean, how hits per second graph will be looks like? How hits per second this particular graph should like looks like, and how this particular graph should look like? I'm talking about a graph here. How we are going to expect this ramp up graph? How it is going to be? It's a kind of exponential, right? I hope you are able to follow what I'm trying to say here. Say here, you have a graph like this. Say this is a graph, okay? So in this graph, what I'm saying here, you are saying that 5 users per 1 second, and you wanted to pump up 300 users. So it may be like this, right? Okay. Are you able to understand this one? So it's a kind of a exponential, because for each time frame you are basically pumping up some set of users to the application over here. Okay, so this is the ramp up graph. And how can you guess how a hits per second graph will looks like? Any guesses on this? How a hits per second graph will looks like? First of all, did you understand this one? Please be respond. Don't be idle. If you really don't understand, you can say that you really don't understand. Don't be idle. Talk something. Okay. First of all, did you understand this one? I'm saying here, 5 users per second. Okay, like that we are pumping up for 1 minute here. So here a graph will looks like this, like a exponentially. The graph will looks like, because for every 1 second you are basically pumping up 5 users over here. Okay, now based on this, and now I'm asking you to guess how this graph will looks like. Can you just think? Now how this hits per second graph will looks like? Yep, here, just think. You are saying that 5 users, maybe you can say that 1 user per, maybe you could say 1 user per every 5 seconds. Even though in that case also your graph will looks like the same. Okay. In this case also your graph will looks like the same over here. Okay. Basically you are doing a ramp up. ramp up, basically, you know, you are saying that you are pumping up the users for every 5 seconds. You basically are pumping up one user. Maybe in 1 minute, there will be some 12 users will be logged in, right? Maybe in 1 minute, there will be 12 users will logged in, right? Are you able to follow this? So it means from from the 0 second, maybe you will have one user. Maybe after 5 seconds, you will be having two users. After 10 seconds, you will be having two users like that. So whenever time increases, okay, as time increases, okay, users are increasing. Okay, graph is like a exponential. Now graph is becoming okay, exponential. I hope everyone is clear with this. Okay, I hope everyone is clear with this, right? Yes or no? Now here, whenever users are increasing, it means say at 0 second, maybe at the 0 second, you can say that there is one user, right? And after 5 seconds, it means at 5 seconds, you'll be having total two users. After 10 seconds, how many users? You'll be having three users. After 15 seconds, how many users? You'll be having four users. Like this, now whenever you reach the 60 seconds or here, how many users? You'll be having 12 users. It means when you plot a graph, when you plot a graph, now this will be like, you know, on your x coordinate, and this will be your y coordinate. I hope everyone knows the basics of a graph. Is there anyone here who don't know about graph? X coordinates, y coordinate. I hope everyone know about this one. Okay. Now if you closely observe here, now whenever the users are increasing, what actually user is going to do? See, whenever the users are increasing means what an user is going to do? User is going to send the request to the server, right? Okay. Now here, at the 0 second, you will be having one user over here. Maybe one user will send one request over here. Okay. And two users here you have two users. Maybe each user may again send some other request. First user may send one request, and second user may send another request. Okay. Here maybe two requests. And here maybe two requests or maybe three requests. It depends. Okay. But however, what is happening here, in the simple words, whenever your users are increasing, your number of requests has been will increase over here. Okay, why? Because each user will not keep quiet, right? Each user will try to interact with the server. That is the purpose of our performance testing. When the user is logged in, means user is interacting with the server. User is interacting with the server means user is sending some request. So when you send a request, it is nothing but your user is hitting with some data with the server. So whenever there are number of users are getting increased over here, whenever there is number of users are getting increased, it is nothing but the number of requests are getting increased, which is nothing but it is going to have h per second. Whenever there is a ramp up, users are there. Okay, it is expected to that h per second also should increase like this. I mean, it should be like a symmetry over here. I hope everyone know the word symmetry. Now I'm saying that your hits per second will be symmetry with your ramp up, or in other words, the way of users are getting logged in, the way of users are getting logged out from the application, accordingly your hits per second there. Okay, say if your users are logged in this fashion, say for example, users are logged in like this, like this, they are logged in, and they have been, we can configure like this also. Say if users are logged in and logged out and logged in like this. Say if user graph is like this, okay, your hits per second graph also will accordingly will vary here. I mean, it may not be exactly the same way, but it will be like a symmetry over here. Is that clear? Any questions on this particular graph? Any questions on hits per second graph? Any questions on this user graph? I'm saying that your hits per how your users are getting logged in, how your users are getting louder, accordingly your hits per second graph should looks like. Any questions over here? Actually, I don't need to explain this particular thing right away here. I'm just making you to clear some points so that you know the further class maybe it will, you can yourself you can think and you can analyze the things. Okay, basically I can simply say that you know hits per second means you know number of requests has been sent to the server. That's it. I can simply say and I can come back to the topic, but here I'm making you clear with you know some kind of a graph mechanism, because going forward it will be very easy to understand other topics. Okay, in simple words there is something called hits per second, and simple words there is something called throughput. Did you all remember throughput? We already discussed as per my guess. Did you remember throughput? No, yes. We did not discuss. Did we discuss about throughput? Okay, again there is some metric called throughput. We'll be discussing a bit later. Okay. So as of now, what you can do here, just assume that these are the some metrics. Okay, hits per second is one metric. Say if your server hits per second is very high. Okay, Devon is saying that you talked about it, but did not discuss in detail. Okay, fine. Might be probably yes. Yep. However, no, these are the things which are like some metrics. Okay, so these are some server metrics. Based on this, we can understand how healthy our application. Maybe we will be discussing these things, or we'll come back here. So now here, see here hits per second 100. It means they are expecting that 100 hits per second. So this is our goal over here. Okay. So with the minimum number of users 50, maximum number of users 150, and it is trying to execute this one. Okay. Now if you want to edit this, there is something like edit scenario goal. And here by default it is saying hits per second 100. There is something like hits per second 200. Again, apart from this, basically if you see here define scenario goal here, basically you can configure with the virtual users. You can configure with hits per second. Transactions per second means I hope everyone remember the what is meant by transaction. You remember the transactions, right? Okay, so for example, say you have logged into the EB application, okay, and you are doing a transaction of you are checking out. Okay, say for example you are checking out transaction. I'm doing a kind of click on add to cart. So I'm doing add to cart and you are doing a checking out. So say assume we are doing both of us doing at the same time. Okay, so at a particular point of time, okay, you are doing a checking out, I'm doing some add to cart. So at particular second, how many transactions that our server can handle? Say there are 5,000, say here, say if you say if your server can handle 5,000 transactions, means per second our server can handle 5,000 transactions. It means each user is doing something. Okay, one user may be doing a login, one user doing maybe logout, and one user may be doing adding an item to the cart, and one user is doing some kind of checking out. Like that, okay, 5,000 transactions has been happening. That 5,000 transactions can be any transaction over here. Okay, now here we'll say that transactions per second, and here you can configure the some transaction name, and here reach goal of 100 transactions. You are saying that 100 transactions per second. It means my application should be able to handle 100 per second over here. Okay, with the maximum users 150 users. Okay, so if we execute this one, it will let us know the metrics. I mean, it will let us know the what type of things that you have to use over here. Okay, so we are saying that my goal is 100 transactions should handle my server. Okay, so however, as I said, you know, ultimately this will not give any purposeful results. Okay, so this is I can say, you know, it is a kind of a theory. In real time, generally we will not use goal oriented scenarios. Okay, so here we'll simply say that this is our goal. So accordingly, script will execute and will let us know. Basically, it is going to do an emulation of the things. Okay, now let me close all these things. First of all, we'll try to create some two scripts here. Okay, by using virtual user generator. First of all, we'll create scripts. Okay, basically, I don't have any scripts here. Okay, so first of all, we'll create some two scripts, and then we'll make use of those two scripts here in our scenarios over here. Let me say, eBay, or you can take any other application too. Let me say eBay 1. We don't think, we'll just rename this. Just a naming, and we'll be creating a script over here. Let me create a script folder over here. Now let us record, and let us record here and as part of user underscore init, and here let us give
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.